baby.
Hey, did everybody welcome Steelo yet?
What up, Steelo?
Hey, everybody, hey. You know, we're at the hottest spot in Vegas. It was crazy. Obviously, there's a lot of EDM music, raves, and, you know, people just doing four on the floor, moving kind of like this. That's how everybody danced in Vegas. It was extra crazy that night. Everyone's getting drunk, shots after shots after shots. I didn't eat a lot that night. I ate a salad. So if you can imagine cognac just hitting kale and tequila just hitting a tomato, like, it is not gonna hold it. We had a guy that walked past us as we walked out of the club. He thought these two girls were with us, and he said, "Can I holler at them?" "I don't care, bro. Do your thing." And he said, "Yeah, I thought so." Now, I don't know why I thought took that as being very offensive, but it's probably because I was drinking him. And when you drink him, you turn into Tupac. So I told my brother, "Hey, can you turn around real quick and punch that guy in the face?" Frank turns around, doesn't ask me any questions. Boom, right in the kiss. But my boy, who's always in Vegas, is like, "Hey, man."
I did that just for you.
"Hey, man, in Vegas, you only have 2 minutes to get the hell out of here." I didn't really believe him in the beginning, but then as soon as the security came around the corner, he's like, "Told you." So we bounced, boom, started running real fast. We split up, though. I'm gone. I mean, as fast as I can go in my tight-ass jeans. I had on these real tight St. Laurent, though. They're pretty baller. And I'm trying to run, but I'm starting running sideways, galloping kind of. And there's just security guards coming out in every direction. Like, you know, they all look alike. It was the same people. I ain't being racist. It was the same security guard, left and right. It's like two guys. I'm like, how the f*** you work for this hotel and this hotel? You know, it's always that one security guard that wants to abuse his power a little bit. He came over with his hand on the pepper spray, as if he was the quick draw McGraw. Like, he was ready to just let loose with the pepper spray.
"Look here, we don't want problems. Just come with us."
I'm like, "Nah, man." He sprayed his pepper spray like this, all loose, like he didn't want to get in his eyes. And he ended up spraying four of his partners. My hand goes up, and then my next reaction was to run the hell out of it. And I just run until I start hearing the voice, "Steelo." And it's my brother, it's Frank. "Get your ass in this cab right now." We get to the hotel room and we're both just going insane. Like, you ever seen Boys in the Hood when Cuba Gooding Jr. starts swinging at the air for no reason? That's me. I'm like, what the f*** just happened? And naturally, I don't know why or how, but I wiped my eye. One of these. There was mace on my hand. It hits me instantly. Starts to burn the out of my eye. Naturally, the only thing I can think of is to jump in the shower. So I grab a towel with the same mace hand like an idiot. I gradually make it down to my dick. It's weird because I didn't clean to my armpits or my shoulders or anything. I just cleaned my dick. So my dick starts burning like horribly. Right. My dick burning, my eyes burning. I'm gonna die like this. Frank's like, "Dude, you need milk." So Frank calls down room service. They give me a glass not that much bigger than this. I take it, run in the bathroom, and just dip my dick in this milk. This milk felt like heaven wrapped around my dick. Look, I'm not trying to tell you to take a milk bath, but if you took a milk bath, it might feel amazing.